We want to solve the system of linear equations by graphing. To solve a system of equations, we want to determine the x and y value that satisfy both of the equations. And to do this graphically, we're going to sketch a graph of both lines on the same coordinate plane to determine the solution. Let's quickly review what can happen when we graph two lines on the same coordinate plane. Well, if two lines have different slopes, they will intersect, and the coordinates of the point of intersection will represent the solution. So if two lines intersect, we have one solution. And we say the system is consistent and the equations are independent. If you graph two lines and the lines are parallel, then the system has no solution, and the system is inconsistent and the equations are independent. And the last possibility is we graph both lines and it's the same line. In this case, we have an infinite number of solutions because the two lines share an infinite number of points. And the system is consistent, but this time the equations are dependent. Now let's go back and graph our two lines. We can use any method to graph these two lines, but since the first equation is in standard form, let's go ahead and complete a table of values and we'll determine the x and y intercepts. We can determine the y intercept by setting x equal to 0. We can determine the x intercept by setting y equal to 0. And when a line is in standard form, this is often a convenient way to graph the line. So if x is equal to 0, notice how this would be 0. We'd be left with negative 3y equals negative 6. We divide both sides by negative 3. And we have y equals 2. Now if we set y equal to 0 and solve for x, this would be 0. We'd be left with x equals negative 6. So let's go ahead and graph this line, y-intercept of positive 2, x-intercept of negative 6. So there's the blue line. And now notice the second line, which we'll call the red line, is in sloped-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b, where b is the y-intercept and m is the slope. So line 2 has a slope of 1/3 and a y-intercept of positive 2. And this is more than enough information to graph this line. We'll plot the y-intercept at positive 2. And then since the slope is 1/3, we'll go up 1 unit and right 3 units. But notice how in this case, we're still on the blue line, which means the blue line and the red line coincide or are on top of one another, which means they share an infinite number of points in common, and therefore there are an infinite number of solutions. Again, every point on the red line is also on the blue line, so there's an infinite number of solutions to this system of equations. And when this occurs, we classify the system as consistent because there is at least one solution, but because the two lines coincide, the equations are multiples of one another, so we say the equations are dependent.